All right, we're rolling. In this video, everyone, I'm gonna focus on spatial depth and noses and drawing is sculpting. I'm gonna try to talk about the importance of angles, visual balance when you're adding value shapes, darks and lights, okay? I've noticed that my AP art kids are skipping out on the nose. So we went ahead and we're starting to study bridgeman's head, face, and features. Head, features, and faces. So they are less afraid of noses. It's Inktober, and it is a great chance for us to draw a nose because the prompt is boogers. Yeah, so let's like think about spatial depth, guys. Okay, if something is closer to you, it's gonna be larger. So for this week's assignment, I would like you to draw a nose close, head far away. Here are your materials, heavy drawing paper, grayscale markers. You need to think about value. Guys, start with a light pencil, but then jump to ink right away. Be bold with your marks. Eraser just for the light pencil part as you're getting the angles right. Your precise pen. And our class text, okay? So let's just like focus and be serious about the value of drawing a booger. We are never done learning, okay? Now I want you to have a good reference photo where we can really see the anatomy of a nose. Nose is a sphere. And as you're carving in, I want you to channel Bridgeman's sphere, sphere, sphere. And then the angles going back. So I want the nose closest, eyes far away. So we can't shy away from the schnoz. When you first start going in, I want you to just think about angles in your reference. And yes, you can put that booger in because there's value in drawing a booger. But here, as I'm sculpting it out, I'm really, really just thinking in angles and twisted forms. As far as visual balance, I want there to be the eye and the booger, two heavy things, a booger and an eyeball, right? That's where the eye's gonna go when looking at the composition. So I'm thinking about the roller coaster of the eye, and then I don't want the other nostril to be alone. So there's a booger. But guys, see right now, I'm just like carving out the angles and making adjustments and thinking what is closest, what is furthest away. Step one. Step two, that's when you're starting to think darkest dark, lightest light. So the pen, you're starting to put in dots and little reference points where you want the eye to go, because the eye is gonna go to the darkest dark. So it's gonna enter from the left of the composition dark, and then it's gonna go to the booger. Right? Now I know this sounds crazy, but like there's value in drawing a booger. Let's talk about mark making, AP art. That is a way to create movement, right? So thinking about the roller coaster of the eye. I want the eye to go to the eye, nostril, booger, right? So my marks are gonna show the momentum of the booger shooting out of my nose, right? Now also, don't obsess about drawing teeth if you have a shot like this, because you're just drawing the negative space. So often when you're drawing, it's not about drawing each tooth, it's about drawing the empty space around it. So you're thinking about the angles of forms. Now, something to think about and why I want you to watch these videos, notice how I'm going all over the space. I'm not getting stuck on the booger, I'm not getting stuck on, I'm jumping. I got my pen. I'm like, okay, where's my darkest dark? Where am I gonna put some stipples? Stipple here, stipple there, stipple there. Visual balance, it's even, right? I'm always looking at my photo, okay? I am not ignoring it, and I have a mood board you can see with my booger, right? But I'm like, okay, where is it dark? Where is it light? Always thinking about the light source dancing around the page, right? So as far as visual balance, right? I got their mouth and then the booger's got a mouth, right? So everyone's got some teeth, right? Keeping the eye move. It's not, my composition is not just about one thing. It's about multiple things, right? There are several layers. I want the eye to move around. Several focal points, several points of interest, more dynamic. So when you put in your darkest darks, then you want to bounce around and be like, okay, where are my mediums? Where are my medium value shapes? Okay, think of values as shapes. Okay, I got a dark shape right here, right? I got the dark value shape under my nose, and I'm seeing that, and I'm starting to carve it out. Drawing and painting are carving. It's almost like 3D art. You're just kind of chipping away. Where's my empty space? Where's my dark shape? Bouncing around, moving around. Why should you move around the page? So you can create unity, right? So if I have like these marks here, these marks here, these marks in the teeth, these marks in the booger, these marks in the eyebrow, putting the hatching in the background, putting the same hatching here, it's gonna like move the eye throughout the composition. Instead of it being stagnant and stuck, we want it to move. The spatial depth, the big old schnauzer, if I'm tilted with an interesting angle, it's gonna be more exciting, easier to look at. My eye can go in this way from eye to here. So you're thinking in warms and cools. Okay, we talking so much about color. I wanna hear you talking about value, okay? Yeah, you could talk about warm colors and cool colors, but let's think about value. Okay, so moving all over the page, carving out, making adjustments, right? Instead of doing outlines, I'm drawing from the inside out rather than the outside in, right? Trying to really make it be 3D. Now, what is a nose but a big old sphere, right? So I have my dark grays, my medium grays, and then my lights. Now I'm working my lights in, trying to make the schnoz look 3D, right? Now, hatching helps it to be three-dimensional, right? So I'm telling my viewer the path of my face, right? The curves of my nostrils, right? By the direction of my hatching. So when I talk about value of mark making in class, it's like, okay, are our marks going in different directions? I don't know if they are. Sometimes, but do our marks have purpose? I'm seeing people hesitate, like, oh, I'll put in some hatching here. No, there should be intention to your marks. It's like, I'm showing you that my eye's curving up. I'm showing you that it's bending. Now, I know I'm not talking so much about the booger, but because I'm drawing the booger and I'm focusing on the path out of the nose, I have to draw the environment of the booger, which is the nostril and the face, which is a bending form. So there's great value in drawing a booger because it forces you to draw the face in a weird way because the focal point is the booger. How am I going to create visual balance, though? The eye needs to be just as crazy. Nostril, so eye goes throughout. Okay, planes. The face has a lot of planes, like the inside of the nostril goes in. So I've got hatches, several curves, right? So if I'm showing the side, the bottom, I'm gonna hatch this way, that way. So when I talk about planes, it's like the face has several planes and I wanna show the direction of those planes, just like I would from a form. If I was drawing a box, I would change the direction of my hatching. If I was drawing a cube, I would change the direction. So I'm going to change the direction of my hatching with a face or a booger, right? And the hatching can create movement, which is a principle of design, shooting the booger out of my nose. Action. We want to excite the AP board with things jumping off the page, like boogers. Now, I know you may not have a booger in your sustained investigation, but notice there's great value in having something come out at the viewer. It's exciting and dramatic, right? So right now, like I'm actually channeling Bridgeman's, right? And I'm drawing the planes of the lips going out, thinking that the teeth are flat. Teeth aren't perfect, right? There's just the weird angular things going in different directions. Thinking about the shadows that my lips are casting and the light. Right, where's my light? It's coming in from here. My lip is casting a shadow, right? constantly moving, constantly layering. Ashley Mirafuentes always said, class of 2021, I just got to keep working at it, right? So you never give up. Now bringing down, adding those darker values at the end throughout. I'm going dark value here, dark value here, dark value here. Why? So there's visual balance. I don't want the viewer to just go one place. I want the viewer to move throughout. The viewer will follow the dark values and the dark flying booger splats. There is great value in drawing a booger, okay? And why, this is why we do Inktober, because it opens up possibilities. Because who's afraid of a booger? Are you? Bring down the dark values in the background, right? Help me to understand what's behind so the form comes forward in space. Often the background will solve itself with the direction of your marks, because that kind of creates a path for an eye. And if you're repeating to create unity, to make everything cohesive, repetition, 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 then maybe the background's going to be a bunch of repetition, right? But this, so much of the background is the face, because who is the protagonist in this video? The booger, right? And don't forget the little booger's friend in the other nostril. Eyeball, booger, booger. That's visual balance. Visual weight, visual weight, visual weight. I hope this video is helpful. This is a serious video. I'm not joking. Because we want the nose to come out forward, a value of mark making, a variety of value. I need to see more variety in your pieces. Shouldn't be so flat. I want something coming out, okay? This is a serious video. Good luck, YouTube and AP Art.